Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Labs on Protection of RTD Measurement Systems. In the last video, we went over component selection for the RTD measurement system. In this video, we will analyze the impact that the protection circuits have on performance. Specifically, leakage current and leakage drift will be calculated and measured. In general, a common shortcoming of TVS diode datasheets is a lack of detail describing the statistical distribution of leakage current and leakage drift. As part of this investigation, we measured a small sample of TVS diodes from different manufacturers to get a general sense of the statistical distribution of the leakage and the drift. There are two main error sources introduced by TVS diodes: capacitance and leakage current. Capacitance of the TVS will vary according to the standoff voltage applied across the device. This change in capacitance will introduce nonlinearity for systems with AC input. Since RTD circuits have DC inputs, the parasitic capacitance doesn't really impact the performance here. In previous videos, we covered examples with AC inputs that showed THD performance impacts from the parasitic capacitance. Leakage current is another important error source. Leakage will flow through the input impedance and introduce offset voltages. This error source can be minimized using calibration, but leakage drift over temperature is typically difficult to calibrate. The table shown provides the maximum leakage current for some different commercially available TVS diodes. Unfortunately, diode manufacturers generally do not publish typical values for leakage or leakage over temperature. Later in this presentation, we will show that if the leakage is equal to the specified maximum, then the offset error can be unacceptably large. For this reason, we did an investigation where we measured large batches of different TVS diodes to get a better understanding of what to typically expect for a leakage current. The results showed that typical performance is significantly better than the specified maximum. This video will cover the error analysis, assuming worst-case leakage, and review typical results. Here we will calculate the error from TVS diode leakage. Look at the circuit on the right side. The leakage current from T3 and T4 flows through both the RTD sensor and reference resistor RF, as well as the lead resistances RLead1 and RLead3. The leakage current I2 from T2 flows through RLead2, RLead3, and the RF reference resistor. The leakage current I1 from the T1 TVS diode will flow through RLead3 and the RF resistor. The leakage current of SMB-J14CA is 1 microamp maximum at room temperature. The conversion result for this RTD circuit can be thought of as a ratio of the RTD resistance to the reference resistance with the gain factor. The ideal ratio can be calculated with the first equation, resulting in 0.8. This ratio doesn't include any leakage current error sources. An expected ratio can be calculated by including all the leakage current sources in nodal calculations, and then substituting these nodal calculations into the ideal ratio relationship. In this example, the expected ratio is 0.795. Note that this assumes that all the leakage currents are the same in each diode and equal to the worst-case leakage. Furthermore, this analysis assumes that all the resistors in the circuit are equal to the stated value, so some error sources will cancel out completely. In a practical circuit, the resistors and leakage currents will all have tolerance, but this simulation doesn't take that into account. For now, comparing the ideal ratio to the expected ratio, the calculated error is -0.625%. For this kind of circuit, a common accuracy target is 0.1% or 0.5%. So based on this initial calculation, the diode solution will not be able to meet the design goal. Now, let's check the error with the TI TVS diode solution, the TVS-1401. Most TVS diode manufacturers only show a maximum leakage current at room temperature in their datasheet, for example, the SMB-J14CA. This makes it difficult to evaluate the error contributed by the TVS diode over temperature. The TI device is specified over temperature, and also provides a typical specification at room temperature. The TVS-1401 has a very low leakage current of 30 nanoamps maximum at room temperature, compared to 1 microamp of leakage current from the SMB-J14CA. The TI-TVS diode datasheet specifies maximum leakage current at high temperature, which is 260 nanoamps. Also, the leakage current versus temperature graph is shown in the datasheet, which is very helpful to estimate the error for designers. Using the same equations for error calculations, the TVS-1401 error is only 0.16% at 85 degrees Celsius, which is much lower than the SMB-J14CA, even at room temperature. Based on the calculation, the TI-TVS diode solution can meet the design goal of plus or minus 0.5% across the full temperature range. This slide shows measured accuracy on hardware with the TI-TVS diode TVS-1401 solution in blue and the conventional TVS diode SMB-J14CA solution in red across the full temperature range from minus 40 degrees Celsius to 85 degrees Celsius. For this measurement, a low drift and 0.01% high precision resistors are used for the reference resistor for the highest accuracy. The RP1 and R1 resistors are also low drift precision resistors, as the matching of these resistors can have some impact on leakage current cancellation. The RTD in this example is substituted with two different precision resistors to emulate an RTD at 0 degrees Celsius and at 850 degrees Celsius. The objective of this test is to illustrate how the leakage current and leakage over temperature impact circuit performance. Both TVS diodes performed better than the calculated error based on their specification. The SMB-J14CA device's calculated error was expected to be 0.625%, but the worst error measured was 0.042%. The TVS-1401 device's calculated error was expected to be 0.159% over temperature, and its worst error was 0.038%. You might be surprised by the small measured error of the SMB-J14CA as compared to the calculated error. Based on our characterization of some common commercially available TVS diodes, this is not unusual. It seems that most manufacturers of TVS diodes only provide a maximum room temperature leakage current specification, and generally, this specification seems to be substantially greater than the typical expected leakage. We will look at the measured diode leakage on a set of SMB-J14CA diodes more closely later. This slide shows measured resolution at different temperatures. The objective is to show that the noise and signal integrity is not impacted by the protection circuit. The effective number of bits, or ENOB, is greater than 21 bits across temperature. Also, the noise-free resolution is higher than 18 bits across temperature. These measurements both meet typical design goals for this kind of system, and it is clear that the addition of the protection components had minimal impact on noise performance. This slide shows the diode reverse leakage current characteristics across voltage. This diode is rated to have a reverse standoff voltage of 14 volts and is expected to break down between 15.6 volts and 17.2 volts. For this measured group of diodes, there is a clear breakdown between 15 volts and 17 volts as expected. At 14 volts, the specified maximum current is 1 microamp, but you can see that for this group, the highest leakage is 410 nanoamps at 85 degrees C. In the next slide, we will show the curve for minus 40 degrees Celsius. Diode leakage will increase with temperature as is shown here. However, in real-world cases, condensation at cold temperatures can cause additional leakage. The measurements made here were done in a nitrogen-purged environment so that condensation isn't a factor. This slide shows the minus 40 degrees Celsius graph of leakage versus reverse voltage, and the table summarizes the average result for all the diodes measured. The highest leakage measured at the 14-volt standoff voltage is 410 nanoamps at 85 degrees Celsius. As expected, the leakage when a lower reverse voltage is applied is much smaller. For a 5-volt reverse voltage, the maximum leakage is 78 nanoamps. This is an important finding, as our design uses a TVS diode with a 14-volt standoff voltage, but normally applies only 5 volts across it. This is an important benefit of using a TVS diode with a standoff that is greater than the normal operating voltage. Here we summarize and compare the accuracy of the Born's and TI TVS diodes. In this table, the TI diode is based on maximum specifications and the Born's diode is based on average leakage measurements. One important point to understand here is that reducing the applied voltage to about 3.5 volts substantially reduces leakage and consequently reduces error. Unfortunately, most diode manufacturers do not provide detail on typical leakage distributions, how leakage behaves over temperature, and how leakage changes with applied reverse voltage. This can make it difficult to estimate error based on datasheet specifications alone. Often, using the datasheet specifications for diode leakage can lead to an overestimate of expected leakage, and this error may be unacceptable from a product specification perspective. When including a TVS protection scheme in your product to prevent against damage from electrical overstress, it may be necessary to characterize the diodes to better understand any undefined leakage characteristics. It may also be necessary to confirm product accuracy with a production test if the TVS diode leakage specifications lead to unacceptable errors. The main point of this presentation is to show that it is possible to use TVS diodes to protect the ADC inputs and still meet accuracy targets. But it can be challenging to do this based on published specifications alone. The final slide in this presentation shows a sinusoidal fault signal of 60 volts peak-to-peak applied to the input. This is just one example to show the clamping action of the TVS diode, but any other transients can be applied to the input. The circuit was designed to withstand a plus or minus 40 volt DC fault. DC faults are very challenging, as they will dissipate significant continuous power in the TVS diode and series limiting resistors. The circuit will be able to withstand short transients much greater than 40 volts. For this example sinusoidal fault signal, you may notice that the clamp signal is a bit higher than the absolute maximum voltage rating of a voltage input. However, the ADC is protected as long as the input current is limited to less than the absolute maximum current rating of plus or minus 10 milliamps. Therefore, this circuit is an effective input protection for the sinusoidal waveform. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content. Question 1. True or false? TVS diode leakage will decrease at high temperatures. The correct answer is B, false. Leakage for all diodes will increase with temperature. Question 2. If a TVS diode is specified to have 1 microamps maximum leakage at the standoff voltage, 14 volts, what leakage will be below the standoff voltage, 5 volts? The correct answer is B. Leakage at 5 volts will be lower. Leakage will always decrease when the reversed voltage is decreased. Question 3. True or false? TVS diode datasheets typically do not provide information on how leakage changes over temperature, what typical leakages are, and how changing the reverse voltage impacts leakage. Based on the limited specifications, it may be difficult to accurately predict error. The correct answer is A, true. TVS datasheets typically provide information on maximum room temperature leakage at the standoff voltage, and this may not be sufficient information to accurately predict error.